Hello and welcome to In-Depth. My name is Aditi Nagpal Kirotra. Under President Donald Trump, the U.S. started a new chapter in its battle against immigration by barring visas for pregnant women seeking to enter the United States for so-called birth tourism. The decision took effect on Friday, explaining the need to protect what it called the integrity of the green card. The White House said foreigners were using visas to secure automatic and permanent American citizenship for their children by giving birth on American soil. The White House also said the birth tourism industry was a glaring immigration loophole that threatens to overburden valuable hospital resources and is rife with criminal activity. The U.S. Constitution guarantees automatic American citizenship to anyone born on U.S. soil. A White House official said that an estimated thousands of children were born in the United States each year to women who arrived in the country using B visas, and the number was rising. In In-Depth today, we look at what is the meaning of birth tourism, the extent of the problem, the immigration laws in the U.S., and also why a U.S. green card is such a coveted possession for people around the world. The United States is taking action to curb birth tourism in the country. The anti-immigration measures are part of President Donald Trump's agenda to crack down on the misuse of visitor visas to the U.S. Accordingly, the U.S. has barred issue of visas to pregnant women seeking to enter the country for the primary purpose of giving birth.
The Trump administration is imposing new visa rules to restrict birth tourism. Effective from 24 January, the new policy is an attempt to deter foreign nationals from traveling to the U.S. to give birth in order to get American citizenship for their children. The State Department says traveling to deliver a child in the U.S. is not a legitimate activity for pleasure or of a recreational nature. The new rule applies to visitors seeking temporary visitor visas or B visas that are issued to non-immigrants. It allows U.S. consular officials to deny a visa to any individual whose primary purpose is to give birth in the U.S. Pregnant women applying for U.S. visitor visas may need to prove they have a specific reason for travel other than giving birth. The policy adds that the birth tourism industry is rife with criminal activity, including international criminal schemes. It also tightens rules on those wishing to enter the U.S. for medical treatment. It requires visa applicants to prove they have the means and intent to pay for their medical expenses. The rule does not apply to the 39 countries that are part of the visa waiver program, most of them in Europe, that allows citizens to come to the U.S. without a visa for temporary stays.
Any lady delivers a child in United States, pregnant and went to deliver a child in United States, then through naturalization, the child can get American citizenship. And if you can add on to your citizens one after another, then somewhere United States doesn't, they want to restrict the inflow of people into United States because, you know, Trump was elected on the platform of anti-immigration. He opposed immigration rules. He opposed immigration, and particularly immigration of the dark people. So that is the reason that they want to control it.
Nearly all children born in the United States of America get automatic citizenship as per their constitution, even if their parents are non-citizens or even lack the legal documentation to be in the country. The 14th Amendment to the U.S. Constitution states that all persons born or naturalized in the United States and subject to the jurisdiction thereof are citizens of the United States and of the state wherein they reside. Applauding the new policy, the White House Press Secretary Stephanie Grisham said, "Closing this glaring immigration loophole will combat these endemic abuses and ultimately protect the United States from the national security risks created by this practice. The rule will defend American taxpayers from having their hard-earned dollars spent on costs associated with birth tourism. The integrity of American citizenship must be protected."
See, the thing is, it is, as I said, it is a right of every government to devise the kind of laws they want. You can crib about it, but criticize it, but you cannot curtail it. They are well within their rights to impose restrictions. They don't want this to become an industry, and frankly, it has become an industry. There are many of the agencies, travel agencies and others, who have become billionaires out of this kind of business. They are charging $40,000 to $80,000 for this bird tourism. The women from Russia, from China, from Philippines, from other countries, from India also, some people have gone. And Mexico and all, I mean, they just come illegally. Then they give birth to child. Child becomes entitled to this. So there have been this. And US, if it is not the first time that they are doing under President Trump. There was something called DACA. Under that regulation also, they had started controlling and denying the right. So it is in keeping with his overall policy to curtail immigration into the country.
Currently, pregnant women can enter the US even up until they give birth. While there are no official figures, the State Department said foreigners arriving in the US to give birth is increasing in recent years. The US has been cracking down on the practice before Trump took office. The Center for Immigration Studies estimates that 33,000 children were born to women on temporary tourist visas between the second half of 2016 and the first half of 2017. The US has also sought legal action against people capitalizing on the birth tourism industry. Last year, three people were charged with running birth tourism for Chinese clients in Southern California. It was the first time criminal charges were filed in a US federal court over the practice. Since the beginning of his tenure, Trump has been critical of birthright citizenship and other immigration laws. In his presidential campaign, Trump called for eliminating birthright citizenship. The issue was revived before the 2018 midterm elections and is once again coming ahead of the 2020 presidential vote. With inputs from Kunal Singh, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Immigration and Nationality Act of 1952, also referred to as the Nationality Clause of the US Constitution, sets forth legal requirements to acquire US citizenship. People become citizens either at birth or through naturalization after birth. The US also offers dual citizenship.
US citizenship may be acquired either at birth or through naturalization after birth. To become a citizen at birth, a person must be born in the United States or have a parent or parents who were citizens at the time of their birth. Persons born outside US may acquire US citizenship through naturalization, which is a process in which a non-US citizen voluntarily becomes an American citizen. For that, a person must be at least 18 years old, able to read, write, and speak basic English. They are also required to be permanent resident or green card holders for at least 5 years. The United States also offers dual citizenship or dual nationality, which means a person may be a citizen of the United States and of another country at the time. A person who becomes a US citizen through naturalization is not a natural-born citizen. Consequently, naturalized US citizens are not eligible to become President or Vice President of the United States. Adult citizens have the right to take part in the country's political system as well as the state and local governments.
You can acquire US citizenship in different ways, but birth, being born in the US, automatically confers the right of citizenship unto you, as per, as I said, 14th Amendment of the US Constitution provides that. So if you are born in the territory of the United States, whichever territory fully, you will be entitled to the US citizenship.
A person will no longer be an American citizen if he voluntarily gives up his citizenship. A person can also lose his citizenship in specific cases, like running for public office in a foreign country, entering military service in a foreign country, intentionally acquiring citizenship in a foreign country except if required through marriage to a foreign national, committing treason against the United States. In the last decade, the US welcomed more than 74 lakh naturalized citizens. Among the highlights for fiscal year 2019, US Citizenship and Immigration Services naturalized 8,34,000 new citizens, that is an 11-year high. USCIS also granted lawful permanent residence to nearly 5,77,000 individuals. In 2019, the number of applications pending for green cards and naturalizations were reduced by 14% and 12% respectively. With Kunal Singh, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
With this, we'll slip into a short break, but we'll be back soon. Stay tuned with us.
The government is set to slash the requirements and time taken for starting a new business from 10 processes and 18 days to 5 processes and as many days.
It's another institutional forum for coordination of state policy towards businesses, like GST Council, will be a helpful instrument. So there, a lot of these issues, nuts and bolts issues affecting businesses on a day-to-day basis, can be discussed.
Overall cost of doing business in the country has to be brought down in a manner, again, in an integrated manner, where states and center are looking at this thing together and bringing out policies where your overall ease of doing business ecosystem is such that, you know, businessmen can start businesses quickly.
It takes a lot of education and learning to go through the entire process to bring everybody onto the new system, right? So implementation also is the key.
कैसे हो चुनावी राजनीति अपराधियों से मुक्त? सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने किसे दिया फ्रेमवर्क तैयार करने का आदेश? क्या दागियों को टिकट ना देने का विकल्प हो जरूरी? देखिए देश देशांतर रात 8:30 बजे सिर्फ राज्यसभा टीवी पर.
Watch the big picture with me, Frank Rousen Pereira, at 9:30 PM.
Among the inseparable identity of Delhi, Qutub Minar has stood by the test of times and elements. Struck by lightning a few times, the 240-meter star suffered damages on its top story. Firoz Shah Tughlaq and Sikandar Lodi had commissioned the repair under the rule, but the damage most remembered was the one in the 19th century, when an earthquake had damaged the topmost story in 1803. The responsibility of the repair was given to a British officer, Major Robert Smith, who had placed a pillared cupola on the top of the minaret. After massive criticism, the then Governor General Harding ordered the cupola to be removed. It was reinstalled at the ground level to the east of Qutub Minar. It still remains there, known as Smith's Folly.
आपका विश्वास. देखिए आपका कानून हर रविवार सुबह 10 बजे से लाइव सिर्फ राज्यसभा टीवी पर.
Welcome back. You're still with us on In Depth. Green card is a privilege that allows bearers to reside permanently in the United States. Green cards can be obtained through marriage, familial sponsorship, or employment. There are several circumstances under which card holder can also lose their residency rights. Our next story is about the rights and responsibilities of lawful permanent residents.
A green card or a permanent resident card allows its holder the legal right to live and work permanently in the United States. It is issued to immigrants under the U.S. Immigration and Nationality Act. Green card holders can serve in the United States Armed Forces as well as other law enforcement agencies. They can work anywhere in the United States with the exception of most federal jobs and some companies under contract by the federal government. They are also protected equally by the law of the United States, their state of residence and local jurisdictions. Besides this, green card holders can travel freely outside the United States for up to a year as tourists. They can also petition for immediate family members to immigrate to the United States as lawful permanent residents. These family members include their spouse, unmarried children under 21, and parents of US citizen who is at least 21 years old.
And US citizenship also gives green card. And that green card has been obtained by several people across the world. And once you have green part, you have card, you can settle there. So suppose your kind of son is working in United States and also you apply for green card and eventually you get it. Then no, you are a citizen and then you enjoy all the citizenship rights. And you are protected like any citizen.
Green card holders are eligible for many social and economic benefits including research grants, insurance coverage, social security, state sponsorship in education and retirement earnings. Green card holders also have certain obligations towards the state. They must maintain a high level of moral conduct in the United States. They are required to obey all laws of the United States, including state laws and localities. In addition, they need to file income tax returns and report their income to the U.S. Internal Revenue Service and state taxing authorities. Males between the age of 18 and 25 years need to register with the Selective Service System. In addition, a green card holder is denied the right to vote in the U.S. elections, serve on a jury, and can't possess an American passport.
First step is always green card. So once you get the green card, you can come there. You have to comply with the conditions, which means you have to be there at least, I think, 6 months or 8 months every year. You have to be there for a couple of several years. And then your number comes and then you can apply for citizenship and then you get the citizenship in the country. So it is a stepping stone which permits you that. So this is how the US system works.
Having a green card is not an entirely secure status. It can be withdrawn and the green card holder can also be deported under certain conditions. A green card holder may abandon permanent residence by filling up withdrawal form at a US embassy. If green card holders fail to fulfill their responsibilities towards the state or commit a criminal act or violate a law, they could lose their permanent residence status. Although the green card says permanent residence, it is valid only for 10 years for permanent residence and 2 years for conditional permanent residence, after which they need to be renewed or replaced as applicable. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha Television.
So why is citizenship of the US one of the most coveted in the world? It's because there are many opportunities that are available only to citizens of the US.
Becoming a US citizen is the next logical step for most green card holders, especially if they intend to stay in the United States for the long term. Even though the green card itself comes with several benefits, US citizenship has many advantages not available to green card holders. Once you become a US citizen, you cannot be deported to your country of former citizenship or nationality. You will have just as much right as any other American to live and work in the United States. Even if you are charged with a crime in the future, you will be able to stay on in the US. With US citizenship comes a US passport, which is considered one of the most powerful passports in the world. A US passport will let you travel to more than 180 destinations without a visa for short-term trips, take as many trips abroad as you want for as long as you want, and seek assistance from the local US embassy during times of trouble. US citizens also get federal benefits. Citizens have full access to certain government benefits programs such as federal college assistance. A US citizen can apply for a green card for their relatives, including parents and siblings. Upon getting citizenship, your minor children automatically become US citizens even if they are born abroad. One simply has to report a child's birth to a US embassy or consulate. Only a US citizen can apply for a US government job. In fact, most federal employment is reserved only for US citizens, and federal employment is coveted because federal employees and their families tend to receive relatively better benefits and earnings than private sector workers. Only a US citizen can vote in the country's elections. Non-citizens may only vote in some local elections. Citizenship also gives you the right to run for elected office.
See, US has been a country of dreams. They've been selling dreams. This is the largest economy in the world. It is the most advanced country in the world. It is the most powerful country in the world. It is the most innovative country in many sense. And it has created it is the country of opportunity. And that is why, I mean, the fact remains is that, forget about others. As far as Indians are concerned, those people who had gone 30, 40 years ago, today are like in the Microsoft and others, they are actually the CEOs, the top CEOs. It was unthinkable at any time. And these, some of these companies, their turnover is equal to the GDP of many countries. So to have that kind of an opportunity to be there, to grow in that kind of an environment, is what attracts people there. Because this is a country where your dreams were built at one time.
There are other benefits too. While lawful permanent residents live, work and pay taxes in the US, they do not have the same access to public benefits. Citizenship ensures equal access to critically important benefits for older people and people with disabilities. However, there are some duties too that a US citizen has. A US citizen is required to file income tax returns for life, no matter where you live. As a US citizen, even if you move abroad, you must still file income tax returns in the US. A US citizen may also be called upon to serve in the military. Mandatory military service enforced by a draft was officially discontinued in 1973. However, if reinstated, a US citizen could be drafted to serve. A US citizen may also be called upon to serve on a jury. In the United States, jury duty in a legal proceeding is mandatory. If summoned, you must attend, but you may not necessarily be chosen to serve. Only those who are selected by the judge and the attorneys after being summoned actually serve on the jury. With inputs from Kunal Singh, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
So that's it from us today in In-Depth. We'll be back same time on Monday with a focus on another key subject. You can also watch our program online on YouTube. Suggestions and feedback about the program are also welcome. Thank you so much for your time.